Hi, Natasha here, sports dietitian at NMC Nutrition. Today we're going to talk about the top three sports nutrition tips for CrossFitters. So my guest with me today is Eric Mosquera, sports dietitian from Ecuador. Eric, gracias por estar aquí con nosotros hoy día.
Muchas gracias, Nati. Thank you very much, Nati. My name is Eric. I'm a sports nutritionist here in Cuenca, Ecuador. I work with CrossFit athletes. So today I'm going to talk about three advices that can increase your performance if you are thinking to compete in a CrossFit competition.
I love it. And I wanted to mention as well, we met Eric through an international sports nutrition conference and we stayed in contact after that. So you did most of your schooling in Ecuador, but I believe you also have the IOC nutrition diploma, sports nutrition diploma as well. So can you talk about your education a little bit?
Of course, I graduated from the career of nutrition and dietetics here in Cuenca, Ecuador. I am a member of the ISAC, the International Society of Anthropometrics. I'm a level 2 certified member. I'm also a PANS representative global member, and I'm doing my IOC sports nutrition diploma. I'm currently finishing my second year of the diploma.
And wonderful.
In this September, I'm going to study in Liverpool John Mills University to start my master's degree in sports nutrition. So okay. That's my background, and that's what I'm going to do for a long time.
Wonderful. So now I've worked with some CrossFitters, of course, but you have definitely specialized in that domain. So I'm really excited to see what you have for your top three sports nutrition tips for CrossFitters.
Of course, let me tell you a brief history about what when I started to work with these athletes. So I think that in 2018, I went to a competition here in Cuenca, and I saw a lot of competitors that were like doing these high intensity workouts, and they didn't have enough time to eat and to drink anything. So I started to feel tired when it was like the evening, and I didn't compete at that days. So I remember that I said, wow, if I feel tired, how these guys should feel after all these workouts. So today I'm going to talk about what I start to investigate after that situation. And the first advice is to drink a lot of rehydration, sports nutrition, sports drinks, if you are training for more than 2 or 3 hours. And this is very common because a lot of competitive CrossFit athletes try to drink only water during their trainings. But the evidence shows that if the athlete is going to train a lot of time, it is better to rehydrate with sports drinks like Gatorade, Powerade. Yes. Or I usually use like a special formulation. Like we use 1 liter of water, 60 grams of sugar, 3 grams of salt, and drizzle of lemon. So with this, you can rehydrate in a better way. The other recommendation that I give to my athletes is that they can also eat some carbohydrates during their training sessions. If they are going to train like 2 or 3 hours, it is better to eat something in the mid session, like at the 1 hour and 30 minutes.
Yes.
It can be like a fruit. It can be a sports gel. It can be a bread with jam. I think that most of the athletes feel okay if they don't eat a lot of fiber. So they prefer like a banana instead of an apple. And this is in the competition season of the general preparation of a competitive athlete. If we have another athlete that only trains for 1 hour, I think that it is better to rehydrate with water, and it doesn't matter if he eats during his training carbohydrates, because it is not going to make another a big difference. My second advice is for the competitive athletes to avoid high fat, low carbohydrate diets. The main reason for this is because CrossFit is a high intensity sport. So the main source of energy of the body is glucose and glycogen. So if the athlete is eating a high fat diet, their body is going to adapt to this diet and is going to utilize the fat in their diet in a better way. But at the same time, the carbohydrates that they are eating or that they have in their muscle are not going to properly be utilized by their muscle cells. So they are going to be in, they are not going to perform in the best way possible. And my last advice for these athletes is to invest their money wisely. I saw a lot of misinformation in social media about supplements, and a lot of athletes here in Ecuador think that they need like 6 or 7 supplements in order to increase their performance.
That's everywhere.
Yeah, I think that's everywhere. So there are few substances that can help to improve the performance of an athlete. I'm going to name every one of these substances. Caffeine is one of them, creatine, beta-alanine, and sodium bicarbonate. But we have to think about 3 aspects with these 4 substances. The first one is that every athlete needs the assessment of a sports nutritionist. Like, there are 4 substances, but there is no need to utilize all of them in order to increase the performance. The second aspect of this advice is that we don't know what is going to happen with the performance or the body composition of a person that took that is taking like caffeine, creatine, beta-alanine, and sodium bicarbonate in the same day or during 12 months. Mm-hmm. There should be a way of thinking that you can utilize one of them. If, for example, if you didn't sleep well yesterday, you can drink caffeine in order to reduce your tiredness or the sensation of tiredness. But currently, the amount of scientific evidence shows that there is no need to take a lot of supplements because the amount of performance that we can increase is like 3%. Mm-hmm. And maybe this is important for a competitive aspect, but for a lot of athletes that only train because they want to feel better or to look better, that there is no reason to keep just taking supplements in order to increase your performance just for 2% or 3%.
Especially if nutrition's not where it needs to be, right? That 2 to 3% is when nutrition is at its peak. But if they're not eating or hydrating properly, they're not even going to get that 2 to 3%.
Of course.
I really like that.
So three advices. Do not try to follow high fat, low carbohydrate diets. Mm-hmm. It's going to decrease your possibility to perform at the best in the high intensity training workouts. Try to rehydrate with sports drinks, or try to eat carbohydrates during your training sessions if you are training 2 or more hours. Mm-hmm. If you're training less than 1 hour or 1 hour, you can drink just water and you don't need to eat anything during your training. And the last advice, don't try to use a lot of supplements. They are not going to increase your performance as much as the nutrition is going to do with you. That's it. Hope that this helps.
Absolutely love it, Eric. What I wasn't expecting so much good information in one sitting. This is fantastic. And it's, you know, studies show that you rehydrate up to 10% faster if you do have that sodium in there. And I really appreciate that you pointed out the difference between a competitive CrossFitter and a recreational CrossFitter, or somebody just trying to get in shape, because it's 2 different approaches, or even 2 different sports almost, because you do have to fuel differently. You have to periodize it to your training. So I really, really appreciate that you pointed that out.
Yes, that's like the main difference that I can get from my practice. like I have a lot of clients that they are only want to look good and they don't train a lot of days or a lot of time. So to be able to make this difference between these two kind of athletes in CrossFit is very important. What I always say to my competitive athletes is to try to always think about refueling yourself, rehydrating yourself, and preparing yourself for the next training session, because that's the most important thing.
110%. I agree. Now, obviously, this information is just as necessary in Ecuador as it is in Canada. So I am happy that you're sharing this important information. Now, for athletes looking to get in contact with you, I know you have a wonderful, high quality online sports nutrition course. I believe it is in Español solamente.
Yes.
So can you share that course information and I guess your information for your Instagram and your Facebook as well?
Of course. So you can get in touch with me in my Instagram or Facebook to ericmosquera.es. And my course about sports nutrition, we create a course of 6 modules. In each module, we show different aspects of nutrition, like how sports nutrition calculate calories for the athletes, how we calculate the proteins, carbohydrates, fats. And we talk a lot about supplements and ergogenic aids. And finally, well, I always try to invite different sports nutritionists so they can have, the students can have different opinions and points of view from different sports nutritionists.
Wonderful. And so for those of you que habla español, I strongly suggest that course, very high quality course. And I will put all the information for the course as well as the social media handles in the description of this video. So thank you so much, Eric. Muchas gracias una vez más. And I appreciate you being here with us today. And I think you'll agree with me in saying, like I always do at the end of these videos, nutrition is a science, not an opinion. And so la nutrición es una ciencia y no una opinión.